Hi, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me today. Please like, share, and subscribe. It's been about a month since I've covered the earthquakes that are occurring there in Maine, so I thought I would catch up on some of these quakes. The most recent, actually it was down here by Vermont, was a magnitude 1.5 on the 17th. Kind of shallow, 6.5 miles below sea level. It's down here at the bottom. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. 71 people said they felt that earthquake. A lot of people didn't realize it was an earthquake. There was a loud boom. And according to geologists, that boom was because it was so close to the surface. USGS gave an intensity level of 4, meaning it was felt indoors by many, outdoors by a few. If they were sleeping, they would have been woken up. Dishes, windows, and doors disturbed. Automobiles would have been rocking noticeably. Here on USGS is the felt map. Let's see, intensity level 4 up over there, north of where the epicenter was. Intensity level 3. Interesting, too, down over here there was one response intensity level 4. Lately, everything I found on the swarm view is being caused by the earthquakes down there in Mexico. Here we have the 1800 hour. Let me go ahead another 4 hours. And is it going to move for me? Hold on. Let's see. There's actually 2 earthquakes from Mexico in this mess. All right. And you can see how it was trailing off here. No earthquakes here. And this is Tuesday, September 20th. And that's today. Yeah, that's my grandson in the back playing his video games that he got home from school, and nothing there in that time frame. There is one right here. I noticed the earthquakes that are showing up on the monitor there in Maine. They got to be a magnitude, probably about a 5.4 before they show up. And let's move ahead another 4 hours. Nothing here. Let me bring it over for you. And go ahead another 4 hours. If I can get it to go. Let's see. All right, there we go. Another 4 hours, nothing. And another small quake. Again, this is from Mexico showing up there in Maine. And this is what it's currently showing. There you go. Geologists will blame ancient faults that are under the surface. But I notice most of the earthquakes that I have mapped out are actually along the Norumbega fault zone. And I've covered this, I believe, back in August. In fact, it was, this month. Yeah, September 1st. There was several earthquakes in this location. There's a 2.6. Let's see. We got a 3.0. Is that it right there? Okay. September 17th. Let's see. I think I did that one for you. Let me go in a little closer so I can see. Okay, this 3.0. That was August 17th. And it looked like there was a fault line going right through here. Altogether, 14 earthquakes. 1.7 on August 16th, and then at the other end of the fault, August 11th. Let's jump around here a little bit. August 13th, the 16th, the 13th. Many of you follow me probably remember me covering these. 11th. Let's see here, the 30th. So if you'll see here on the Maine Geology Survey website, they only list earthquakes that people sent in reports that were felt. If they didn't send in that they felt it, then they didn't post it. This is why it's so important. If you feel an earthquake, you should send it in to USGS Did You Feel It website. most of the earthquakes there in Maine are probably caused by the Nuremberg fault zone. It is one of the longest fault systems that they have, in fact, studied there in the East Coast. Now, in the area of Sand Hill Corner, it's a shear zone. And they know that there is high stress, a lot of pressure that has built up. And that area is anywhere on the fault zone 300 to 500 meters wide. So Sand Hill, the fault zone, is about almost 900 feet to over 1,600 feet wide, I believe it is. Trying to remember. And this little square, that is the area where there is high strain. A lot of tension has built up. 71 people there in Greenwood, Maine said they felt that 2.3. So let's go to that location. Yeah, many of them said it was a booming sound, not really a rumble. Right there. Okay, we got Greenwood, West Paris, territory of South Oxford. And then down here by Stoneham. Let's bring that out, showing how close it was to this high strain area. I tried going back to the weekend to see what kind of earthquakes there were, but you can see here the monitor isn't working. And in fact, this is the only monitor there in Maine that I can find that is working. In fact, I went all the way back to Wednesday. Yeah, there's no data. I don't know why, if it was just down that long or they don't store the data. Yeah, it really raises a lot of questions. So a good example of why, if you think you felt something, you should send it in to USGS. Did you feel it? Even if they don't list it. They do have a page, which I will give you the link to. And over here on the right, it says report an unknown event. So thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe. Always prepare for a disaster. You never know when one's going to hit. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.